There is evidence of a giant planet lurking in the outer solar system at more than 1,000 times the distance from the sun as Earth, and could be as much as 25,000 times fainter than Pluto. Astronomers are gazing into this abyss in search of Planet 9. Welcome back to Launchpad. I'm Christian Reddy, your friendly neighborhood astronomer. In our previous video, we looked at evidence for a large planet that would be lurking in the outer solar system. And this planet would explain the orbital clustering of several trans-Neptunian objects. However, evidence of a planet is not nearly as good as finding the planet itself. And in this video, we're going to talk about how astronomers are doing just that. Mike Brown and Konstantin Batygin of Caltech ran several computer simulations to determine what kinds of orbits Planet 9 could have. But all of them are highly elongated and tend to point away from the clustered objects. That means from our vantage point here on Earth, Planet 9 should be confined to a band that is encircling us around the sky. Even so, this band is still a really large search area. Fortunately, there are some clues that help us narrow down where in the sky to search. Planet 9 is estimated to be about 10 times more massive than Earth and comes no closer than about 300 astronomical units to the sun. Even though that's 10 times farther from the sun than Neptune, Planet 9 should still have been bright enough at that distance to have been detected in previous surveys. An examination of recent surveys showed no evidence for such a planet, and this suggests that Planet 9 is probably near its farthest point from the sun, or aphelion. And that makes sense because as planets approach perihelion, they speed up, whereas when they approach aphelion, they slow down. Planet 9 should therefore spend most of its 20,000-year orbit near aphelion, but its aphelion distance could be as much as 1,000 astronomical units. At that distance, Planet 9 would be 25,000 times fainter than Pluto. But telescopes like Keck and Hubble should have no trouble finding Planet 9, but their fields of view are incredibly small. And the search area in Taurus and Orion is something like 4,000 times the size of the full moon. So using Keck or Hubble would be like squinting through a soda straw. But there is a telescope that's right next door to Keck. It's the 8.2-meter Subaru telescope, the national telescope of Japan. Subaru is equipped with the Hyper Suprime camera, an 870-megapixel camera that can capture 6 full moons worth of sky in a single image. Planet 9's aphelion should be somewhere between the constellations Orion and Taurus, making the search area visible from September through February of every year. Subaru should be able to cover the search area in about 20 nights. That may not seem like a lot of time, but astronomers who want to use Subaru to search for Planet 9 have to compete with other astronomers for time on the telescope. Not only that, but bad weather interfered with the first 2 years of Planet 9 searching, so only a fraction of the search area has been covered to date. At this rate, it'll probably take a few more years before the entire Planet 9 search area is completely covered. Luckily, a second team of astronomers led by Scott Shepard from Carnegie Science are also using Subaru to conduct their own search for Planet 9. Even better, Shepard's team are also piggybacking on another survey with another telescope. The Dark Energy Survey uses the 4-meter Victor Blanco telescope at the Cerro Tololo Inter-American Observatory in Chile. The telescope used the Dark Energy Camera, or DECCAM, mounted at the telescope's prime focus. DECCAM's field of view is twice the Hyper Suprime Cam mounted on the Subaru telescope. But its detector is 300 megapixels smaller and is mounted on a telescope that's half the size of Subaru. Even so, Shepard and his team used the Blanco telescope to discover several new trans-Neptunian objects that are even fainter than Planet 9 is predicted to be. So this tells us that the search for Planet 9 is in fact possible. And by the way, these objects all follow orbits that are clustered in a manner that is consistent with Planet 9. Now you might be wondering, well, how come they can find these tiny objects when there's supposedly a giant planet that they haven't found yet? Well, the answer is, we expect there to be thousands, maybe even hundreds of thousands, of these tiny objects, but only one giant planet. It's like going fishing in the ocean. You expect to catch a lot of small fish, but you don't expect to catch too many whales. But what if neither Subaru nor Blanco find Planet 9? Well, that would be unfortunate, but it wouldn't necessarily rule out the planet's existence. It could be that it's simply on a different part of its orbit, and so a different region of the sky would need to be searched. Or it could be that Planet 9 is on a much larger orbit than predicted, and its aphelion would carry it farther away, making it too faint to be detected by Subaru. But there's another possibility that gives us the screaming heebie-jeebies. Planet 9 could be passing in front of the Milky Way, lost in the glare of a crowded field of bright background stars. Fortunately, there's another telescope that's under construction that should be able to resolve Planet 9 even among such a crowded field. The Large Synoptic Survey Telescope will make the widest and deepest scan of the southern sky over the course of a decade. LSST is armed with an 8.4 meter mirror and a gigantic 3 gigapixel camera with a 9.6 square degree field of view. That will give LSST the sensitivity and clarity to detect Planet 9 even if it's fainter than expected and even if it's passing across the Milky Way. Not only that, but LSST will complete a full scan of the entire sky once every 5 to 7 days and repeat that process over and over again for a decade. That means that every point in the sky will be imaged by LSST more than 800 times. This means if Planet 9 is on a completely different orbit, or is farther and therefore fainter than expected, LSST should be able to detect it as long as it's somewhere in the southern sky. Meanwhile, the search for Planet 9 continues. It's November 2018, and Mike Brown and his team have time scheduled on Subaru in December. This will mark the third year searching for Planet 9, and hopefully a little bit more of the sky will be covered. But each year brings new discoveries of distant objects in the outer solar system, each of which seem to be pointing the way to Planet 9. There are so many new worlds waiting to be discovered, both right here in our solar system and far beyond. If you'd like to join me on the search for these amazing new worlds, well, please make sure to subscribe and ring that notification bell so that you don't miss out on any new videos. Until next time, keep watching the skies.